The hardline Islamist Taliban celebrated their total return to power on Tuesday with gunfire and diplomacy after the last US troops flew out of Afghanistan to end the two decades of war. Taliban fighters quickly swept into the airport and onto the tarmac, fired weapons into the sky across the city in jubilation. Congratulations to Afghanistan, this victory belongs to us all. Taliban spokesman Zabihullah Mujahid told reporters hours later on the runway of the airport. The US military has completed its withdrawal from Afghanistan to end a brutal 20-year war, which has been America's longest. The last American soldier to leave Afghanistan was Major General Chris Donahue. The Department of Defense said in a tweet, Major General Chris Donahue, commanding general of the 82nd ABN Division, 18 Airborne Corps, boards a U.S. Air Force C-17 on August 30, 2021, ending the U.S. mission in Kabul. 9 new Supreme Court judges, including 3 women, were administered their oaths of office by Chief Justice N.V. Ramana on Tuesday morning. It is for the first time in the history of the apex court that 9 judges took oath of office at one go. Chief Justice of India N.V. Ramana administered the oath of office to the new judges in a swearing-in ceremony held in the auditorium of the Supreme Court's additional building complex. The opposition has condemned the gaudy display of lights at Jallianwala Bagh Memorial in Amritsar, which was inaugurated by the Prime Minister after a 2-year revamp. The renovated memorial and the gaudy lights show have been criticized by members of the public and opposition leaders who accuse the government of destroying history. Rahul Gandhi tweeted, "Such an insult to the martyrs of Jallianwala Bagh can only be done by those who do not know the meaning of martyrdom. I am the son of a martyr. I will not tolerate the insult of martyrs at any cost. We are against this indecent cruelty." South African scientists said they identified a new coronavirus variant that has a concerning number of mutations. The so-called C12 variant was first identified in May in the South African provinces of Mpumalanga and Gauteng, where Johannesburg and the capital Pretoria are situated, the scientists said in a research paper. By August 13th, it had been found in 6 of South Africa's 9 provinces, as well as the Democratic Republic of Congo, Mauritius, Portugal, New Zealand, and Switzerland. India's Singh Rajadhana won the bronze medal in men's 10-meter air pistol event, finishing with a total of 216.8 points in the final of the Tokyo Paralympics on Tuesday. Manish Narwal, who had topped the qualification round, disappointed in the final, finishing in 7th position with a total of 135.8 points. This was India's second medal from shooting at the ongoing Tokyo Paralympics after Avani Lakhara won the gold medal in the women's 10-meter air rifle standing SH1 event on Monday.
Subscribe to One India channel and never miss an update.